Storm Ciara has battered the UK and Northern Europe with hurricane force winds and heavy rain. Gwen Baumgardner is in London tracking all the details there. I've seen video, Gwen, that I've never seen before coming out of the UK. It almost reminded me a lot of Superstorm Sandy here in the Jersey Shore when the floodwaters just came rushing in.
Yeah, good morning, Anne-Marie. We begin here in London where the cleanup has begun after Storm Ciara violently swept through the UK this weekend. Britain took the brunt of the storm on Sunday with 2.5 months of rainfall falling in just 24 hours and winds reaching 100 miles per hour. The storm caused significant damage with downed power lines, flying debris, and severe flooding. Some 20,000 homes spent the night without power. Dozens of flights in Northwest Europe were canceled as a result, as conditions were deemed unsafe. The storm is now moving eastwards toward mainland Europe. 5 people have died from weather-related incidents so far. Now to Ireland, where a general election has caused a political earthquake in the country. Sinn Fein, which used to be the political wing of the Provisional Irish Republican Army, has made unprecedented gains throughout the country. Votes are still being counted, but Sinn Féin are firmly in the lead, leaving the two centrist parties that had governed Ireland for more than a century grappling with the power shift. Both of those parties had said they're unwilling to create a coalition with left-wing Sinn Féin, which could create a political deadlock and trigger another election. And finally to El Salvador, where tensions remain high after an armed standoff inside the country's parliament. The president was about to address lawmakers when heavily armed security forces stormed parliament to demand funding for additional vehicles, uniforms, and surveillance equipment. The security forces say the money is necessary to combat violent crime in El Salvador, which has one of the highest murder rates in the world. Critics are calling the security forces' action an unprecedented act of intimidation. Now, despite the disruption in parliament, the president has pledged his support in better equipping police and military. He's giving lawmakers 1 week to back a deal. Anne-Marie.
Gwen Baumgardner, thank you so much, Gwen.